We had a little bit of a sound problem, which we took a great opportunity when they were having all the problems with switching everybody around. So,
so Ki Yoon is pinch hitting now for Dave Lewis.
All right, and what other switches did they make?
So they had to switch out some a higher point value for a lower point value, somewhere down in the order. And we're not sure what that was, but.
All right, play ball!
Tell me.
Well, now they're
He knows.
Okay.
Okay. So, while we're doing it, is there any other switches they did, or just that one for one?
They did two switches.
And who's the other switch we have out there?
We have number 9 going in for B Bell.
Okay. We had a double switch there, so that's an interesting situation. Let's see where their substitution.
So now Keith Wallace's team, the Flyers, are kind of huddling up, making sure everyone is still on the same page here. Key likes to hit it to the right side also. He kind of likes a little sweet spot right over the second baseman's head.
I thought Jose Pena, number 9, was already in the game. Did they switch his location or where he was playing? Or
Jose was already in there. They're not messing with him.
Oh, Guzman. Okay.
There's a hit, and they had a good chance to make a double play. But
no, he's safe.
Key's fast.
So, Key with a single. That's a fielder's choice, I guess.
I'm not sure what they were thinking with that play because just hitting the ball out there is going to get the quad out every time.
Yeah, I thought we were going to see something interesting. Well, that's two away. Ki Yoon's on first. And,
but it does bring up the top of the order now, Paul Moran.
See what Paul can do. This is a one-run game.
So Key's got good speed here, and Paul's got good speed. We got Rue coming up with excellent speed.
And we have Bruce Freud here. Bruce, say a few words to us. Tell us how it's going for the tournament. Bruce didn't have much to say. I think Bruce is really wore out. His voice is gone.
Oh, Bruce has just been laying back, just lazing around.
I don't think I've seen him stop for a minute.
Oh, he's just constantly running. He wasn't even able to come to our warm-up today because he was still coordinating things with volunteers and teams and refreshments. And it's amazing how much work he did to get this tournament going.
Oh, wow, that is hit deep, and that is a ground rule double. That's going to put runners at second and third, and that was so close to being a home run.
So you see where if they not moving that runner to second cost them a run and right there.
Yeah. Well, let's see if Rue can do it. Wataru Hori, Japanese player who's at the University of Illinois and wearing the number 51.
He's kind of struggled in the field this game, but let's see if he can really help his team here with a nice hit to score 2 runs.
Yeah, it's funny. Usually you expect after someone does something in the field that they're not as the top of the form. They usually come back and make it up in a big hit.
This is his chance. He hasn't take a lead with a single here.
That's a foul ball. But so far, he's 0 for 2 with a ground out and a fly out. So he hasn't hit the ball where he wanted to, but
that was a deep foul. That was about a 145-foot foul.
Yeah, you know,
that's what they do with the spare ball.
Does it change the shape after it gets hit that far? Another big hit. That is going to be interesting. The throw to first. Rue is.
Got him.
Got him.
Rene Aquino made a fabulous throw to get him from deep left field.
What a great, what?
Well, they kept the Cubs scoreless again. They left 2 more runners on second
wow.
and third.
Oh, wow. And at the end of 4, it's still 3-2. And we'll be back on X Able in a minute.